By now, we all agree that the field of artificial intelligence, or AI, has seen significant progress in recent years, particularly when it comes to writing source code. What is happening is that advancements in natural language processing have led to the development of sophisticated AI systems capable of doing cognitive tasks that we thought were unique to humans, such as composing poetry, engaging in emotional conversations, and, of course, writing code. Today, AI systems can do many software development tasks better than most engineers. For example, finding and fixing bugs, refactoring code, and even adding completely new features to our existing running systems. Armed with these capabilities, AI agents are threatening to take over many software engineering jobs. This article in the Nature Journal predicted this phenomenon in 2022. In the last months, I have attended a few academic and industrial conferences and also read many research papers on this topic. And I still have the feeling that even world-class experts in the field are uncertain about what's going to happen in the coming years. With all this hype surrounding AI, crazy investments in the tech sector, and the fear of missing out, I think there is still a significant amount of confusion, misunderstanding, and uncertainty around the current and future impact of AI in the software industry. For the folks working in tech, you may wonder if the career you have worked so hard to build is a risk or not. Well, what do you think? Can an AI truly understand the complexities of a software project, from interpreting vague business requirements to understanding the nuances of user needs? In this video, I will give you my answer to this question. And to do so, we will look at current AI capabilities and how they measure up against the demands of real-world software development. So, let's dive in. Anywhere I look, it seems that the media is eager to tell us that AI is going to replace all kinds of jobs, especially software engineers. This is understandable because the traditional media is in the business of creating sensational headlines and monetizing our attention. You have probably seen articles like application development without coding skills, or AI is the future of programming. And this is enough to make you wonder if your entire career is about to be taken over by machines capable of generating entire software applications faster than you can. But wait a minute, let's not jump into the conclusions just yet. We already know that tools like ChatGPT or GitHub Copilot are very, very powerful, but they are not new. Consider a non-programmer who uses an AI-powered application or no-code platform to develop a mobile app to manage personal finances. This is cool, right? But what the article doesn't tell you is that similar applications with ready-made source code are already available online. So a person using AI, like in this example, didn't invent the wheel. He just assembled existing components together. And this distinction is crucial. AI excels at piecing together existing elements, but true innovation, I mean creating and transforming novel ideas into practical solutions that create significant value, requires a deep understanding of the problem at hand. We need to understand that AI systems operate within the constraints set by the limitations of the underlying algorithms that power them and the data they have been trained on. And while AI systems can recombine existing information in unprecedented ways, they lack the intrinsic consciousness, intentionality, and subjective experience that is characteristic of human creativity. Therefore, AI's innovation is fundamentally different from human innovation, as it doesn't arise from personal insights or intentional problem solving, but rather from algorithmic reasoning processes. Nevertheless, as a software engineer, it is good to think critically and recognize the true value of AI for engineering. After a while, I can guarantee you that you will realize that your skills, if you focus them properly, remain highly relevant today. Why is AI unable to fully replicate the work of an experienced software engineer, you may wonder. Let's have a look. At its core, software engineering is about understanding needs, real-world needs. It's about translating problems into clean, structured systems. It doesn't sound super complex, right? Well, it is super complex. For example, let's say the goal is to build a mobile application for booking fitness classes. One solution might be to create a simple interface that allows users to choose a class and reserve a spot. But is that really enough? What if users also want to see instructor profiles, class reviews, or even receive reminders based on their schedule? Should it integrate with the fitness tracker or offer personalized class recommendations? The search space for building a useful app is just very vast. The key point is that software engineers don't just dive into coding an application without fully understanding the deeper needs of the users. Humans have the ability to graph contexts, consider variables like user preferences, time, convenience, and even emotions. This is something that machines cannot do without clear direction from human insight. And this is where AI falls short. Sure, AI can generate code, but it doesn't truly understand the problem. It doesn't think as a human. It lacks a specific business context, and that makes it fundamentally different. It cannot sit down with stakeholders and clarify their needs. It cannot challenge assumptions or deal with conflicting requirements. All it can do is guessing based on patterns it has been trained on. And often, that guess is way off the real needs of the users, because those needs are chaotic. And according to my experience, most users don't really know what they want. In my opinion, this is where human engineers shine. We understand nuances. We can think creatively and adapt to challenging environments. And why does this matter? Because the world needs critical thinking. As long as humans are complex, messy creatures with ever-changing needs, there will always be a demand for someone who can turn these messy needs into clear software solutions. So I believe we should focus on our problem-solving skills instead of writing code, because our ability to define and solve problems is going to be much more valuable anyways. Source code is a way we found to instruct computers so that they can solve human problems. And you may be thinking, what about the software engineering tasks that are more straightforward and annoying for humans? Could AI take over there? Let's dig into that. One of the biggest challenges in software development is that it is error-prone at almost every step. If you misunderstand a customer need, then boom, you end up solving the wrong problem. Misinterpret a functional requirement and you will end up designing a system that is overkill, or worse, one that underdelivers. For example, imagine you are tasked with building a real-time messaging system for a customer support team handling thousands of chats per day. The natural assumption might be to scale up with the advanced microservices and expensive infrastructure to ensure immediate response times. But in a prototyping phase, a more practical solution could involve implementing a simple queuing system to handle chat overflow during peak hours, reducing the need for costly infrastructure while keeping the user experience intact. AI, on the other hand, would probably go with the more typical solution, like adding servers and microservices, because the majority of documentation resources to build this kind of systems explain how it is done in that way. And AI doesn't have the creativity to consider alternative options. It follows the existing data, the information it has been trained on. The difference between a good solution and a great solution often comes down to human ingenuity, finding that less obvious but more effective approach. Why should you care? Well, because the real magic in engineering happens in those transitions, from needs to requirements, from designs to code. These steps are where human insight makes all the difference. And of course, automating the boring part is a great thing. It is what engineers have been doing since the early days, right? However, today is even more important to look for smarter ways to solve problems, because AI might offer you a set of solutions, but it is your job to consider all the possibilities and make a critical evaluation of each of them. So, what does this mean for this whole software industry, where things are constantly changing? Can an AI keep up with those changes? The concept of AI software development is all about flexibility. It is about adapting to change, whether that change comes from shifting market conditions, evolving user needs, or even new regulatory requirements. It is a fast-paced, ever-changing process. And that's exactly where current AI systems based on large language models struggle the most. For example, imagine you are midway through a project when suddenly the market shifts. The client wants to pivot. You need to revise your priorities and adjust the entire architecture of your software. Can an AI do that? Well, yes, it can. But what if the conditions are completely new because of an event that have never ever happened before? Like, for example, a market crash or a natural disaster. AI systems operate based on past data and predefined assumptions. It is not going to sit in a meeting with you, hear the client's concern, and propose a totally new approach. Now, don't get me wrong, current AI can assist in AI development, especially when it comes to routinary tasks like generating boilerplate code or testing. But when it comes to adapting to new unexpected demands, they show some limitations. AI will not replace programmers, but will fundamentally change the development landscape, making human creativity and problem-solving skills essential. Adaptability is one of the most valuable skills in software engineering. As long as the world keeps changing, there will always be a need for people who can pivot quickly and come up with creative solutions. Now, let's talk about the situation where AI actually excels in software engineering and how we can leverage that. Take code reviews, for example. I think it is very tedious. You have got to shift through line after line of someone else's work, looking for bugs, performance issues, or security vulnerabilities. AI agents like those integrated on GitHub or other platforms can help automate parts of this process, flagging potential issues before a human ever gets involved. It can help with tasks that are repetitive, like generating boilerplate code, adding unit tests, or writing documentation. It can analyze large data sets and suggest optimizations. Indeed, many surveys suggest that the developers are eager to get away from these tasks to AI assistants. But when it comes to making the final call, the human touch is still essential. In my opinion, the future isn't about AI taking over, but about humans learning how to work alongside AI to be more efficient and effective. And the engineers who can collaborate with AI will be the ones who thrive in the future. So let's integrate AI into our workflows where it makes sense. Use it to handle the boring stuff so we can focus on the creative and complex tasks. And I know what you may be thinking. If AI can assist in low-level tasks, that means it could eventually replace less experienced engineers, right? Can AI replace entry-level engineers? Well, the answer is yes, maybe, but less experienced engineers don't just exist to do the easy stuff. They are learning, growing, and building the experience they need to tackle more complex problems down the road. AI may be able to take over some of the simpler tasks, but it cannot replace the learning process. For example, if you have been around for a while, it is well known in the industry how much you learn from your first project. It wasn't just about writing down the code because programmers are not typists. It was about understanding the problem, communicating with other developers, figuring out how to structure the solution, and dealing with unexpected bugs along the way. If we remove those possibilities from learning, and instead of that stuff, we put an AI system in place, then it will be harder for young people to gain that kind of experience or develop the necessary intuition to solve real-world problems. So if you are an entry-level engineer, your goal should be not trying to compete with AI. It should be to delegate the tasks that AI can efficiently handle and move on to the bigger or more interesting problems. Keep pushing yourself. Don't get too comfortable with the easy tasks. Just use AI to do those tasks for you. Instead, focus on learning the skills that only humans can master. So, I don't think AI is going to replace software engineers, at least not anytime soon. I'm sure it can handle repetitive tasks and assist in certain areas, but the real value coming from software development still requires human intuition, creativity, and problem solving. Because, again, software development isn't just about writing code. It is about solving problems. And these problems are often really, really messy, poorly defined, and deeply tied to human intuition and creativity. And the main task of engineers is to balance conflicting priorities, adapt to ever-changing environments, and navigate the ambiguous waters between business needs and technical solutions. If there is one way to keep our jobs safe, I think it is to stay ahead of the curve. See you in the next one. Bye.